overlooking his ancestral lands. And what's amazing about this is that on the ancestral lands is horses. Horses are a vital part. They are educators, they are a bridge from the physical to the spiritual. There are spiritual transportation, just not our physical transportation. So there's such a need for the horse knowledge and horse understanding. And if we as the people continue to threaten them, we are threatening ourselves. We are threatening our identity. We are threatening our existence as Indian people, Native American people, whatever label it is that you prefer to go by. And so we as spiritual beings need to wake up and become just that, spiritual beings again. It is time to put an end to the physical side of thought and come back to the spiritual side of thought, so that when we look at things, we see it from a spiritual perspective, in which in turn will help us to see the generations yet to come. Because we don't inherit the land from our ancestors, we are borrowing it from our great children, our grandchildren's grandchildren. And so we need these horses to remain free. It's time to rewild. And the concept of rewild, the understanding of rewild, to be wild is simple. It is simple, simply put like this. What is wild knows how to live with the land, does not destroy the land. What is domesticated, civilized, and trained will always devastate the land. All the things that man creates destroys the environment. All the things that the higher power created, whether you call the higher power God, Allah, Jehovah, or Kantika, whatever it is you call, choose to call the great creator of all creation, whatever the great creator created knows how to nurture and heal the land. And trust me, my relatives, it is time for all of us to understand that we need the horses for our own healing as human beings. I don't care if you're white, Asian, black, whatever color of human skin that you wear, it doesn't matter, because all of us come from the land of this planet. And so we need the horses to heal us so that we know how to see that path that will lead us back home in the spiritual way. So that's all I got to say. So I want to say thank you, relatives, friends, and supporters. We continue to need to band together, set aside our little petty differences, and all come together so our voices will be nice and strong for the horse nation to remain, so that we can continue to live and bring back humanity. Aho, hechitu, mitako ye, oyasi.